Coming up on today's edition of the Art Marketing Podcast, we're talking about going live on Instagram, how to do it, and why you should. Let me start with some housekeeping, if I can, and an apology of sorts, like pretty much all of us out there, we at Art Storefronts obviously have been in crisis mode. We've been forced to get creative in our marketing in these crazy times that we're living right now. And I would say it's really hard generally, and especially currently, to get the hardcore tactical episodes out of this podcast, sort of the ones that it's known for. I think certainly with the frequency that I know many of you would like to see. And I feel bad about that. It's just, it's hard, and it's been especially hard recently. So we've been throwing some different stuff into the podcast feed, as you've likely noticed. The apology is that I've not even had the time to be able to give you the context to what it was or the fact it was coming. So I really do apologize for that. And, you know, over the course of the last few months and even predating the pandemic crisis, as a business, we've been working, you know, pretty hard on getting closer to our customers and just sort of making it a mantra. And so what started with like one-on-one customer calls, like direct consulting, you know, marketing and business, a couple of which we've thrown into the feed, has now morphed into massive group Zoom calls that we're doing with like all our customers. And it's twice a week. And we've been running Facebook Live broadcasts of them as well, sometimes YouTube too, in which we invite our customers into a Zoom call, tackle their art and photography marketing questions live. And I'll give you some info in the end, by the way, if you want to join one of these and check them out. They're pretty cool. But it's been really fun. And although we're still tweaking the format, the feedback has just been tremendous. Like, I don't think we've ever done anything in the history of a company where we've gotten this much positive feedback from pretty much our entire customer base, as well as the people that are watching on Facebook Live that aren't customers, telling us how amazing these things are and so, you know, and how valuable that they are to them. So we've been doubling down on those. I've thrown a couple of those onto the feed as well, onto the podcast feed as well. So rest assured going forward that I'm going to make sure my team labels them correctly, such that if you find they are just not your jam, not what you expect out of this podcast, you can promptly just skip them and stick to the hardcore tactical the pod is known for. So the original naming and numbering systems will stay intact. So as things pop into the feed, if it looks like it'll be easy to discern whether or not it's the normal episode, normal numbers. You know, I think we're on like 41 or 42 or something like that, 43 maybe. Versus the other one. So you can just look in your podcast app, however you may listen to them and skip over them if you don't like them. And again, my apologies for whacking you with those without telling you up front. Now, let's talk about Instagram Live. And for some context, I always love to give a little bit of context. Let's just talk about live broadcasts in general right now. Now, there's quite a bit I can say about them. For context, I'd say I've run probably about 50 of them or so over the last, call it quarter, on pretty much all the platforms, YouTube, Facebook, Instagram. And let me focus on the most important part first. The platforms are at war with one another. And I've touched on this before, but it bears repeating. Facebook, Instagram, yes, I know they're owned by the same group. They're still at war with one another. Google, LinkedIn, YouTube, take your pick. The war is for attention. And it's measured with metrics like time on platform and engagement, i.e. how much time are you spending on their platform and are you liking and commenting and sharing and generally having a good time? If so, they are very pleased with that because all of that is time that you're spending on their platform to the detriment of time that you would be spending on the competitor's platform. It gives, you know, it gives the various social networks platforms more ad inventory to sell. So they love that. You're online longer. You're spending more time. They can show you more ads. So they particularly like that. So, you know, if a tactic, i.e. running live broadcasts, helps increase the time people spend on the platform as well as the engagement, then it stands to reason the platforms are going to reward you for providing them with that type of content. You scratch my back and I'll scratch yours. So lives are just an absolutely amazing way to do this. And I think as a result of running them on any of the platforms, you're going to end up with a ton of free attention that you just would not get otherwise. And a way to think about it is sort of like the golden days when followers or fans of your Facebook called Instagram page would actually see 100% of your posts. Is it that good? No, it's not quite that good, but it's close. It's close. So you get a ton of extra free attention as a result of running these things, no matter which platform you decide to run them on. Now, combine this fact with the dumpster fire of a situation we are currently in, and more people are online than any time in history, and they are left with they is in all caps, the marketing hack of 2020. I think combining all of this, the attention piece, the fact that there are more people online than ever before, the fact that how easy this is, I think this is going to emerge as the marketing hack of 2020. And again, that's regardless of what platform you're contemplating them. And I would say that as we emerge out of this, the lives are going to forever change how businesses communicate with their customers. It's just there's too many good things to them that I endeavor to explain. For today's purposes, we're going to be talking Instagram Live and a little more context, and then we can get into the tactical. And let me just say, the sheer amount of tactical on offer here is like Hunter S. Thompson explaining his drug collection, a multicolored galaxy of uppers, downers, laughers, and screamers. I could probably record 3 straight episodes on it. There's so much tactical involved in this. I find, as I will endeavor to explain, Instagram Lives to be one of the highest ROI marketing activities in the game right now, especially for artists and photographers, given the Chinese Wu flu epidemic pandemic that we are in, the shelter-in-place orders we are under, and its relative newness. The creativity that is being unleashed on Instagram Lives on a daily basis is phenomenal. In the tradecraft, how you go about it, the skills, and get better and better, all of that is just emerging right now, and it's really, really exciting. And its use, and especially like the effective use cases, are evolving daily before our eyes. And let me tell you, those are exciting times. They're exciting times, I tell you. The technology that Instagram has is pretty sublime on how well it works. They've really done a great job with how easy this is to do from your cell phone. What happens when your signal drops out a little bit, how you can resurrect it and get back on it. I mean, phenomenal job to their tech team. Huge, huge, huge round of applause. So it's really amazing. And moreover, it's so, so incredibly easy to do. You press a button and you're live. It's all done with your cell phone. You don't need a computer or any fancy streaming equipment or any lights or anything. Just your phone. You don't even need earbuds or headphones. It works great even without it. So in addition to going live, you're able to bring guests on. You're able to bring guests on the live stream with the push of a button. And it's really cool if you've not seen it. Very few people are properly taking advantage of it, at least at the time that I record this. I think as a result of that, like, there just exists such an arbitrage. And, you know, as I stated earlier, I believe that after this dumpster fire of a situation is over, those that got started and learned the tradecraft are going to benefit for years to come. So I think it's a very worthwhile thing to practice, to invest, to spend time learning how to get good at. So lastly, and this can be an important one, it's this. Nobody gives a damn. Nobody. Nobody cares about your video is not perfect, or your audio, or that you're stressed, or you're not in your Sunday best, or that your hair is not perfectly coiffed, or the lights are not perfect, or you can't hold the camera straight. Nobody cares. There is a lowered quality standard that is just assumed as the norm for these live video broadcasts. And that's a profound thing to say, because normally you would get so wound up in the quality and I got to have a good mic and lights and that. No. There is a lowered standard of quality. So you can just turn things on and go at it. Nobody cares about your background. Nobody cares about the fact that you don't look like you've had a haircut in 3.5 weeks or you need to shave. Nobody cares about your clothes and your shirt not being ironed, not your Sunday best. You can just go at it, ship it. There is a lowered expectation of quality. So I think that's an important point and one that a lot of people get stuck on. So how do you run them? And let me talk about how they work a bit, how to get started, some tactical, then let me talk about the ROI, which is going to be my most favorite part. You pull out your phone, you open Instagram, you go to your stories, you click add to your story. At the bottom of the phone, you scroll all the way down to the left, and there is a live selection. You hit that big round button in the middle, and boom, you're live. I'm not going to make a video out of this, but you can Google it. They're all over YouTube. At the very top of the Instagram app, where all the story icons are, after you've gone live, a new icon appears, and it's yours with a little live text on top of it, a big pink circle around the outside of it. Not only that, but any of your followers that are currently active on Instagram at the time you do get live will get a notification. It's quite brilliant, really, a free notification. So if this is totally new to you, I challenge you to do the following right now, by which I mean pause this podcast, open up IG, go live and start talking and see how it all works. Best way to understand it is to just ship one. So go right now and do it. Don't worry. I'll wait. I'm waiting. Go now. Go. How did it go? Pretty awesome, right? You likely noticed that you were about to press the button and go live. IG, Instagram, even told you how many of your followers were in the app at that very moment, i.e. the amount of people that would get notified at that very moment. So you want to pay attention to that as you start doing these. Once you get into the live itself, your followers can leave comments. They can like and drop you emojis, hand claps and hearts and everything else. There's like a little heart thing in the corner too. I'm sure many of you have seen it already. As people join the stream, you're able to wave at them by clicking the wave button when it appears. And that's sort of just it's this little button as their name comes in, and it just kind of lets them know, hey, I saw you, you're there. Sort of a personal way to acknowledge you see them. Or even easier still, you can just say, what's up, Katie? Thanks for joining the stream. So as the comments come in, you're able to pin them too as a way of saying, okay, I'm going to get to your question next, Stephen. Or you can call out somebody famous that came onto your stream, right? Like if you're doing your stream and Kim Kardashian joined, you'd probably want to pin that so everyone can see that Kim Kardashian follows your streams. I don't know why I brought her up. She sucks. But anyway, no, she's all right. But, you know, that whole thing. It's really cool. It's really cool. These little comments are coming in. You pin one. They know that that's the next one that's going to get answered. Systems on top of systems and on top of systems. It's amazing. People have the ability to request to join your stream. And you can do this with one click of a button, bring them in, and boom, the two of you are on the stream together. It goes split screen, and you're talking together. And you can literally do this as many times as you like. I have cycled through guests, popped into other streams, popped off, and come back on again later in the same stream. Like, it's amazing, amazing what you can do. And, you know, assuming your phone has two cameras on it, one facing forward, one facing back, you can cycle through those views, so you can be showing something forward, i.e. walking through your studio or your darkroom. Does anyone use a darkroom anymore? Your computer where your art is hung, your photography is hung, and show people that way with the camera facing forward, press a button, click it back. Now they're looking at you, and any toggling and creativity between the two of it. So it just gives you all of these opportunities to get like really, really creative, really, really quickly. And it's amazing. And, you know, assuming you have a good cell signal, you can walk around, take people on tours of just about anything. Show people your process, host a game show, do a live concert, whatever. The world is literally your oyster here. And, you know, after the live broadcast is over, you have the ability to save it with one click, one button to your Instagram stories. So with the click of a button, you now have up into an hour of content. I think they cut off after an hour. I gotta follow up on that. I'm not sure. But in your story, so you run one of these, you talk, you bring on some guests, you show your work, you show your process, you do some live painting, whatever it is. And let's say no one even joins your stream. Well, guess what? After you're done, you click save to Instagram stories, and now you have a story for 24 hours, okay? And, you know, making the stories is hard, right? It's hard for a lot of people, you know? I see a lot of artists out there that are not contributing content to the story game all the day. Art Storefronts doesn't. Making stories is hard. So you can't underscore how phenomenal it is to have this ability for one, you know, start talking, start doing your tour and whatever, save it to your stories. It lives there for 24 hours. It's amazing. Now, if you want to talk about ROI, so do I. As if what I just highlighted above is not amazing enough on its own. As it turns out, this gift has a whole lot more giving to do. She's just getting warmed up. Before I get to the ROI though, I need to get to, you know, some of the bad news here. It's not all roses on this deal. There is some. In order to get people onto your stream, you need to have a healthy follower account, which, by the way, is reason number 465, why you need to be moving the attention around all year long. So go back and listen to episode number 40 on how to do that. If you had been doing that all year, you would have had a much bigger Instagram following. Anyway, thankfully, we practice what we preach here at ASF, and I think we have, 12,000 followers or so. And for context, when we go live, depending on the time and without any ahead of time promotion, we're usually getting around 15 to 35 people sustained on at a time at a broadcast. So if your follower count is much lower than that, then you will likely be struggling to get people watching the stream. This is just your typical which came first, the chicken or the egg scenario, okay? So in order for this whole thing to be effective, you need followers on Instagram. You don't want to play to an empty room. So thankfully, I know a lot of you are on this boat. And by the way, I see the people that are going live, and it's like, I'm joining all of them because I'm learning, and I want to learn as much as I can and see as much variety and creativity and everything else. And I find all the time that I'm like the only one. I'm the only one on all these people, you know, and the Art Storefronts account obviously follows a ton of artists and a ton of photographers. And like lots of times it's like crickets. It's just me. So your humble host has you covered. If this is you, you have very few followers on Instagram. You're brand new to it. I'm going to come with some strategies to use if you're in that boat. If you're not in that boat, then get shipping right away. Don't wait. Start running these things and start learning. But you can also leverage what I'm about to outline here too. Okay, so what if you don't have any followers on Instagram, part one? Okay, part one. And again, I alluded to this a little bit earlier, but because I've been popping on to every single solitary live stream I can imagine, from the biggest in the game to all the artists and photographers that we follow, oftentimes I'm the only one on the stream. It shows you, you know, this many people are watching your stream. There's a little number at the top. So I don't want that to be you. You don't want that to be you. For the first couple of times, no big deal. You're going to play with it. You're going to get the hang of it. It's still worthwhile, even if you're in that boat, because then you at least get a story after the fact and you didn't have a story before. But let's talk about what to do in this situation so you're not playing to an empty room. Number one, lean on your friends. Ask them to join your stream and agree on a time. Then you start the stream. No one's on it. Your buddy hops on. At least there's two of you talking. And even if you are playing to an empty room, there's at least two of you, and you're going to get some content for your stream. So that's a great way to get started. Get some practice, experiment with how you bring someone else onto the stream. They'll likely be doing the same thing. They're going to want to do it. So that's a great way to get started. Do that a couple of times. After that, feel like you've got the hang of it, set a time and promote the heck out of it. Promote it everywhere. Make it an event and omni-channel it. And I'm going to go live on Instagram at such and such time, and I will be talking about such and such. Email your list, blast Facebook, send snail mail, smoke signals, whatever you got. See episode 39, by the way, of this podcast on how to omni-channel. It will be in the show notes along with Move the Attention Around. I highly recommend you listen to both of those. Okay, do that and you're going to get people on your stream. Once you have them on your stream, ask them to follow you. You're always trying to move the attention around. You're always trying to get people to like you and follow you in other venues. So send it to everybody. Get on the stream as a technique tactic. Say, hey, if you're enjoying my stream, I'm going to be doing a whole bunch of these. Love to have you join. Love to have you get notified. How do you do that? All you have to do is follow me. You can just go right in the app right now and follow me. Staying on this topic and bringing in a little ROI. I am no joke reluctant to even say this next part. If for no other reason than it's simply so incredibly powerful, I want to hoard it all for myself and my customers. Yet, as is the case with anything, it's about to be out of the bag soon. I'd rather have you hear it here first. When you bring guests onto your stream, their audience is also notified that they are live. And so some portion of your guests' Instagram following will be notified and join the stream. Now, I'll never forget the minute I figured this out, as it left me completely stir-fried till I did figure it out. I was on with an artist, good friend of the pod, Matthew Laca. I was teaching him how this whole thing worked. We were practicing. We were talking shop. A comment came in along the likes of, why is he talking? The he she was referring to was me. And I sat there and I was irked. Here I was hosting a live stream on my account, my Art Storefronts account, and this gal had the audacity to drop the comment, why is he talking? Possibly some expletives slipped out under my breath, but then I figured it out. It was not one of my followers. No, it was Matthew's. They didn't realize it was my live, nor did they care. They wanted to hear from Matthew. So by going live with Matthew, I was able to get my brand and message in front of his 25,000 Instagram followers, all by pushing a few buttons and talking. Whoa, right? Whoa. Take a moment to contemplate the gravity of what I've just told you. Assuming you get creative and you can get some folks with high follower accounts on Instagram onto your stream, you have the ability to get your brand, your art, your photography in front of potentially thousands of people for free. For free. Let that sink in. It's an extremely powerful hack of this thing right now, and one that needs to be exploited. So start thinking about that. Start thinking about the following. How can you get people with high follower accounts onto your stream as a guest, sniper style, but also buckshot style too? What do I mean by that? You do a whole bunch of these, and often with lots of different guests, and you'll be doing just fine based on velocity, i.e., this is the buckshot method. Do a live stream, bring somebody on, drop them off, bring another one on, drop them off, bring another one on, drop them off, go for as long as you can. If you're just randomly cycling through your followers, likely there's somebody in there that has a super high Instagram follower account. So what ends up happening, all of their followers get notified that are online at that moment. They all of a sudden jump in. All of a sudden they're like, who is this? This art looks amazing. This photography looks amazing. I'm going to follow them. Next thing you know, you're marketing to them. Next thing you know, you're making sales. So that is the buckshot technique. but also the sniper technique. The sniper technique is not just saying, I'm going to ship a bunch of these, I'm going to talk to a bunch of people, just by as a result of the velocity, the number of times that I do this, I'm going to get the residue of some of them. I'm going to get lucky and there's going to be some big follower accounts and I'm going to grow some fans. Great. The sniper status, though, is who can you find in your network, okay, that has a massive amount of Instagram followers that would like to engage in some sort of collaboration or do you a solid or any of the above, okay? Any of the above. And that's what I would do. I would sniper them out. I'd say, hey, love to have you on an Instagram live. Love to do this, this, and this. Would you be interested? Yes. Fantastic. Do it. And perhaps you just pick up a few new folks each time and every time, but it's no small thing. So whether you have a large following or not, this is the gift that keeps on giving. And this is a big one. And you really need to think about it and think about the potentials of what it is. That's part one. Part two, what if you don't have many followers on Instagram? What do we love to trumpet on this podcast? Doing the things that don't scale. Automation, automating your business, automation in general is sold in the exact same aisle in the supermarket as passive income is. In case you're wondering and want to look for it, it's aisle 9, what I like to call the bullshit section, okay? Passive income does not exist, okay? I've been seeing this a lot lately and it really grinds my gears. What does everybody want? What does everybody want? What is everybody being sold? Passive income. Everybody's been sold that. This passive income is the thing that you're just going to have a huge business that is just going to magically print you money while you create your art or photography and you don't have to do anything. What a load of bollocks, as the Brits like to say. There is no such thing as passive income. For most artists and photographers out there, you should have virtually nothing automated. Yes, there are some exceptions. But for the grand scheme of things, nothing automated in your business at all. You don't have enough customers. You just don't have enough where the personal hand touch is not the better route. Okay, that rant's over. Let's talk about some hand-to-hand combat that is great for all, but especially with those with low follower counts. Do the hand-to-hand combat. After you finish your live and you turn it into a story, you will have access. It takes a little while for it to turn into the story, a couple of minutes, 5 minutes, 10 minutes, depending on how long it is, sometimes 15. After it's up, you get your story analytics. Now, this is essentially a list with all of the folks that watched your stream. There's like a little eyeball button in the bottom left-hand corner. When you're on your own story, you click it. It shows you all of the people that were on your stream. Right next to their names is the direct message button. It's very easy to work off that list after your stream is over and thank the 10 people personally that were just on your stream, or 5, and ask them what they would like to see more of, right? Say, hey, if you like this stream, I share my best stuff on email. Here's a link. You can use links in your direct messages, right? You can send, I think the rule is 50 of these a day, up to 50 of them a day. So you can get hand-to-hand combat after every one of these streams. You can thank them for watching it. Ask them what we want to see next. Let them know of a sale you have coming up. Let them know how they can get on your email list. Start a conversation, right? Does it scale? No, it doesn't. Is it a damn decent thing to do? Yes, it is. Just the thanking them alone. And your people will love you for it. They'll love you for it. Start conversations with your follower, deepen your bonds, okay? Deepen the bonds. So that's a wonderful way, especially when you don't have a ton of followers and you don't have to send 5,000 of them, right? And you're just going to send 100, 150, 250, and you do it over a couple of days. So there's that. Optimizing your Instagram page, okay? Once you start shipping a ton of these, you start learning and getting better at them. Questions arise as, what is the best way to include calls to action in your stream? So yes, of course, as I alluded to earlier, again, it's the third time I've used alluded in this podcast, or maybe fourth, you should be always asking folks on the stream to follow you on Instagram, right? Like, hey guys, if you're enjoying the stream, I really encourage you to go ahead and follow me. I know people are cycling in and out, so it would be great if you just follow me on Instagram and get notified. I'm really doing some fun stuff. Ask for it, okay? But also, you got to spend some time thinking on your bio, the link in it, whether or not you have story highlights on your Instagram page. You should. All of these things start to become really important once you start ramping up the lives, because you're finding as you're going through them, right? You're going to be constantly mentioning things like, where are you going to send them? The easiest way to do it is send them to the bio. Okay. Send them to your bio on Instagram, because all they have to do is leave the stream, click your name, check you out, look at your work. Is this person worthwhile? So think through what your profile looks like, right? And optimize an Instagram profile. There's a podcast topic for another day. There's a lot that you can do there, but you want to have a good CTA. So think through that. If you're having a sale, have the sale linked in there, have the information prevalent, be able to reference it, say, all you got to do is check my bio. So it becomes really important, more so than perhaps it ever was. Now, all of that was awesome, right? I mean, amazing already with what I've just told you and how I've explained this whole thing. Surely that's it, right? No, no, there's more. Let's talk about above the fold. What is it? Side bet. You know, you're getting old when you have to ask people if they know where it came from. Newspapers. Do young people even read them ever? Not sure. Newspapers folded in half. They had to be folded in half, whether they were stacked in a newsstand or they had to be folded in half when they were placed in a glass case that you would put a couple of coins in and pull one out, right? The stories, the photos, the headlines that are visible in that window or on the top of the folded newspaper is what's called above the fold. Its origin aside, it also applies to websites and apps for what is visible on the screen or in the app when someone's looking at it without scrolling. So if I land on your homepage or your website and I have my phone, anything that I can see on that one screen without scrolling is technically above the fold, so to your computer. And, you know, as the fold goes, step one is being at the top of it, right? And being in it, critically important. And people read from top to bottom. So where do you want your most important stuff, your most important headline to be? You want it to be above the fold so they don't scroll, so the maximum amount of people see it, right? In the newspaper analogy, like you had the above the fold to hook people, to get them to stop and say, I want to buy that paper. So the best headline, you know, the attention catching, jaw dropping, oh my gosh, I've got to buy this paper headline was at the top. So the best thing is to be above the fold. The second best thing is we read from top to bottom, left to right. So you want to be at the top, right? You want to be at the top. And so it's why we love Instagram stories so much. If you create one, you're above the, not only above the fold in the Instagram app, but you're at the top of the fold. So there's a ton of ROI in having a story up all the time. More ROI on the lives? Yep. If you make sure to update your story first, so you put a regular story in, then go live, then when after you're done live, you save the live to the stories, you're going to have, number one, when you're live, you're going to have your regular icon, okay, at the top of the fold for your story that you just did, and you're also going to have the fact that you were live. You're going to have two. Now, they're constantly tweaking with the algorithm. It used to be pretty much you would just see everything normally. Now, I think they're starting to adjust it a little bit, so you're not guaranteed to have this work, but the point is, if you load a story up, okay, and then you go live, instead of just one icon at the top of the bar, on the story bar, you have two. You have two. So that's an incredibly effective way to do that. I mean, the best thing you can do is be at the top. And it's like the Google search results, right? What's the best place to be on the Google search results? The search engine results page, the SERPs page, S-E-R-P-S, what they call it. You search for a topic. What result do you want to be? You want to be number one. That's the best. What's the next best? Number two. You have both. You're cooking with gas. So by updating your story first and then going live, for the duration of the fact that that live is there, you get two spots. Two spots, which is amazing. I mean, it's just ROI for days. Is there more still? Yes, there is. But I think that it's more than enough in this one episode to digest. I think there's enough here to be able to break this thing up into 3, 4, 5 episodes even. So I'm going to peruse that and think through how I'm going to do some additional episodes. And I'm still learning. Everyone's still learning. Everyone's still getting better at these. There's still so much. There's still so much you can do. I haven't even told you what to do after the fact yet, which is amazing. So summing things up, I think the work that gets put in now, learning how to best run these babies for your niche, is going to pay dividends for years after this Chinese flu pandemic is behind us. There is literally a ton of tradecraft to them, and there is no better time than just to start shipping them. I have been advocating for our customers to do these for weeks. The ones that got started weeks ago are already starting to really get good at it. They're refining their techniques. They're getting more comfortable. What do you do with the dead air? How do you pin a comment, answer a comment, come back? How do you bring somebody on? What do you do in the... All of that stuff you just have to learn. There's no course out there that's going to teach you as effectively as just doing it and shipping them. So I think the arbitrage is really, really high for the next few months till the rest of the world figures this all out and the rest of the marketers come in and ruin it for everybody like we're always going to do. So I'm hoping you have not heard about this, or if you have, hopefully I persuaded you. I'm going to turn your head around and you're going to start doing it. I'll come with more content, better content, more videos on some of the tradecraft, and there's a whole bunch more, like I said, to them. They're really, God, they're just amazing, and they're so fun. So I think that's good enough for one episode. I'm going to leave that in the can. Let me pivot, lastly, to our Facebook Live schedule. If you're a fan of this show, if you've been getting value out of this podcast, I really think you'll enjoy the Facebook Lives. Right now, we've been running them 2 days a week, Tuesdays, Thursdays, 11 a.m. Pacific. This is really hard to do. 11 a.m. Pacific, 1 p.m. Central. 2 p.m. Eastern, and all you have to do is go to Facebook, like the page. You'll likely be notified when we go live. We bring all of the customers in. It's up to like 100, 150 on a call sometimes. And it's just rapid fire radio call-in show, art and photography marketing Q&A live. And it's really interesting. And just as many people, you know, even our customers, just sit in the room and watch and listen to them. Don't even ask any questions, because there's just a tremendous amount of value cycling through all of these various different customers and all of these various different niches, what they're struggling on. And it's been amazing. It's like an amazing exercise to just cycle through all these questions, answers. What's the best way to think about this and about that, and marketing questions and website questions, and how many media types, and what about pricing, and how to run sales, and what to do in this COVID time. So they're amazing. Highly recommend you join one. You can pretty much find them. I mean, like us on Facebook or on Instagram, you'll see them. We promote the heck out of them. So I'm gonna leave it there. On that note, thanks for listening. And as always, have a great day.